Today we're going to talk about ADHD and 5 tips for transitioning to college. There's no need to flounder and fail during this exciting time. You can definitely succeed and find your way during this new season of life. I'm Angela Howard, and my passion is to break the stigma of mental health issues among fellow Christians. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe and don't forget to click on that notifications bell so that you don't miss out on any of the new content. I've invited a special guest here today to weigh in on our topic of ADHD and transitioning to college, my son, Benjamin Howard, who's just fresh out of his first semester at Gonzaga University.
Thanks for having me. I was diagnosed with ADHD in 4th grade, so I've been knowingly facing these challenges for 10 years now.
Well, typically people think that it's inevitable for young adults to really struggle during their first year of college, especially those who have a diagnosis like ADHD. You can refer to some of my previous videos to get more information on the types and causes of ADHD. But there are some specific tips that will really help you find success and stability during the transition, and that's really what we want to address here today. So the first tip is to really practice and prepare before you leave. When Ben was at home during his junior and senior year of high school, we started addressing issues that he would face when he would be on his own without us. We talked about warning signs for depression and anxiety and how he could really reach out for help. We started kind of, releasing the reins as much as possible so that he could make decisions on his own and practice for what it would be like in college. Ben, what skills did you find the most helpful that really prepared you for college?
Obviously, remembering to take my medication was a big one, as well as advocating for myself with teachers and kind of learning how I was being perceived by my peers.
Yeah, I remember that. Even though we were really being intentional, we often doubted ourselves as parents. We wondered if we were doing too much or maybe not enough for you. And I kind of was wondering, as you were gone this first semester, what you found the most helpful.
Well, teaching me how to think of the disorder was most helpful to me. Mm. You guys kind of hammered into my head that ADHD isn't what defines me and that my medicine doesn't fix me. ADHD is a disorder I have, and my medicine is a tool I use to help me deal with it. So tip number 2, structure. Creating a daily routine, getting organized, and having the expectation that you'll need to put in 15 to 20 hours of study time during each week is incredibly important.
Wow, I forgot about how much studying it took to really get through college. Okay, tip number 3, focus on your strengths. One of the biggest things that I've noticed that has helped you succeed is really focusing on your strengths. You accept that you learn differently than others, and then you use that to your advantage. How has this helped you during the transition to college?
Well, everybody wants to feel unique, but nobody wants to feel different. So by learning how your brain works, you're able to think of those strengths as unique aspects of yourself and not things that make you different. So tip number 4, setting goals and rewards for those goals. For those of you that skated through high school without doing much studying, you will now find that you're in college and you actually have to buckle down and study every once in a while. And by every once in a while, I mean every week. So that's very hard for the ADHD brain. But what has helped me the most in dealing with this is setting short-term goals while I'm studying and rewarding myself for reaching those goals. So if I have a bunch of notes to take and a bunch of reading to do, I mark a place in the reading where I will take a break and get like a snack or go for a walk. And these short-term goals will help your long-term focus.
I love that. That's so awesome. And yes, it was pretty easy for you in high school, so big transition there. Tip number 5. Connect to God and church community. I think one of the biggest reasons that you haven't floundered during that first semester is being connected to God and church community. What do you think?
Well, I got plugged into a Bible study and a church group within the first few weeks, and that's a huge help to me. It's really important to actively seek out community wherever you are. Mm-hmm. So in college, there are tons of campus ministries and Bible studies just waiting for you to join.
That's so true. I love what it says in Psalm 139:14. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. I know that full well. We are all unique creations of God, and He has a wonderful purpose for our lives, regardless of the struggles that we face. So what tips would you add to the list? Comment below. We would love to hear from you. And please subscribe to more videos. I'll be sharing some great tips and encouragement for whatever you're facing, whether you're struggling with a mental illness or have a loved one who does.